I seek rootedness, it is usually with my bare feet, which is why my offering for this is actually this presentation, where I honor my feet by decorating them in a very particular style, which is my artistic expression, but which is also very typical of the region in West Africa. These shoes were gifted to me by a designer. Well, firstly, good afternoon. Her name is Kani Kamara Samba, and she's a Guinean designer based in Paris. This is her trademark style of shoe, and when I first saw it, I absolutely fell in love with it. I have a few pairs, and this is one that is most well worn. The shoes make a statement in many ways of origin, of connection, of indigeneity. Dakar in Senegal, which is what I regard as my second or third home, perhaps. I was there participating at the Dakar Biennale, and the Biennale for me was one of the most, I would say, one of the biggest turning points in my life. My children's father, my husband, is Senegalese, and that is where I have found a lot of rootedness. It is also the time at the Biennale when I crafted a poem, which is part of my artistic practice. But I really explored this idea of indigeneity, belonging, home. And in fact, what I presented at the Biennale was called Evoking Belonging. It was a collection of poetry, of paintings, audio, where I was voicing these texts. And so what I'm sharing with you now is how I prepared for that and how I presented myself there. Home is this mobile concept for me. I was born in Oxford. It is a place where I have a dwelling place, absolutely. It's a place where increasingly I am setting down roots. It was a very conscious process for me, because in the knowledge that I left South Africa 4 years ago to come here to study and to meet people like you at this course, on this course called Social Sculpture, I left South Africa where I lived for 15 years. And in the meantime, I had been coming back and forth to Oxford. My parental home is here, and currently we are all at home, 3 generations living in edifice. So of course, there's a sense of home, and there's a sense of belonging, and a sense of family in that space. The geographical location of Oxford is a landmark on my map of many homes. Whatever I seek to connect with that deepest part of me, which brings forth the most authentic me, my feet have to be bare. It's the kind of leather, I think it's camel skin leather. And for a while I kind of vacillated between wanting them to be pristine and shiny and beautiful. And then actually I just fell in love with all of the imperfections that I see in the shoe. And I see it as an amazing analogy for what life is. And even this concept of home, it is an imperfect, at least for me, somebody who's grown up in so many different countries, lived in so many different parts of the world, mainly in 2 continents, but different parts of the continent, and experienced so many different cultures, so many different perspectives, so many different ways of seeing life, that I have come to understand that home is a place where I feel a sense of connection. So my travels, and definitely travels in these shoes, epitomized by the leather, the Japanese style split with the toe, it's a ballet pump, you know. So as a designer, I think it's a very interesting hybrid of cultural practices. Nomadic. I call myself the urban indigene, the urban nomad, and you know, people say to me, you ask me a question, where were you born? Were you born in Oxford? And often that's a question that for me evokes many other questions. What is it you really want to know when you ask me, where was I born? Or where am I from? Are you asking about my ethnicity? Are you asking me about my geographical location? Is it as simple as that? Rarely in my experience, is it as simple as that? Once I answer, how do you then see me? I believe it gives you a little chink of me, and by no means tells, not even a quarter of the story. So, in response to that question, I created a poem, and the poem is like this. This is how I introduce myself. So somebody might say, so where are you from? I say, I am of Caribbean heritage, Caribbean parentage, of African heritage, and the skin that I am gifted in is offered to you as the urban indigene. You know, you say that every human being should have shoes, it reminds me often of my father. We're talking one generation away from me, who would often say, who would often say to us as children, and still says to my children, as his grandchildren, look after your shoes. Where you have numerous pairs of shoes, when we were growing up, we had one pair of shoes, and we were expected, and we did, look after them for the entire year. We wore them to school, we wore them to church, we always had a pair of shoes. What does every human being need? I believe it's love. It's the basics, it's shelter. Food, sustenance, nourishment. I feel we take those things for granted in this environment. I observe and I see, with all the material wealth, inverted commas, that exists in this environment, that the deepest yearning and the deepest unspoken trauma often is that of connection, of love. Connection to each other, connection to some sense of being. The idea that being still is an activity is something that I meditate and practice often. Stillness as an activity. For me, it enables connection with those parts of myself that maybe are not so visible. So if I can be remembered for having touched people, for having been able to express and show when I have been touched, because it truly is a gift, you know, and receive. It's about the ebb and the flow of life, you know. Our practice comes from the islands, so when the waves are lapping at the shore, you know, it comes up and it goes down, and all of our movements emulate that. In that exchange where we meet, for me, is that place of beauty and love. I'd love to be remembered for that. Renegade indigene. Triptych passage fragmenting. Blown by trade winds. Source fabric drawstring. Cocooning culture. Wellspring. Resistance gauded. Birth rights, honor, ancestral beings. I write poetry every day. It's part of my practice.
This for me is a way of connecting. It's a meditation. It's